The parathyroid glands are in the same region as your thyroid gland. Actually, they're embedded within your thyroid gland. And they are right here. This is a rather close-up shot. So what we have done is we've cut the thyroid on the midline and peeled it open. And here you can see one, two, here's another one, kinda, and here's another one. Parathyroid gland. They can be anywhere from 2 to 3 to 4 or 5 parathyroid glands. They're usually posterior, which is what you're seeing here, the posterior aspect of the thyroid gland. And of course, they share the thyroid blood supply. And if you were looking at them and not a blown up, and not a close up of the thyroid, they'd be about the size of a pea or a lentil. The parathyroid gland is another example of a gland that is not regulated by the hypothalamus and the pituitary. The parathyroid gland is again regulated by circulating levels of calcium, similar to the parafollicular cells of the thyroid gland itself. So circulating levels of calcium in the blood are going to determine whether or not the parathyroid glands are activated. So parathyroid hormone acts on the bone and acts in response to low blood calcium. So if your blood calcium is low, parathyroid hormone will be secreted. It acts on the bone and causes the release of calcium from the bones. It also will act on the kidney, and the kidney then will increase its production of vitamin D. And vitamin D then acts on the gut to increase the absorption of calcium from your food. So the net result of parathyroid hormone is going to be an increase in blood calcium. So what do I want you to know about the parathyroids? I want you to know where they are, especially with relation to the thyroid gland. Are they influenced by the hypothalamus and pituitary or not? And if they're not, what does activate the parathyroid glands? And then what hormone is secreted by the parathyroid gland and what is its function? If you have a grasp on all of these concepts, then you'll be ready for the assessment.